you all in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Welcome to the Church of the Redeemed Remnant, CTRR. We welcome you all once again to our online service this week. We are glad you could join us. We hope you will be blessed by today's service. Let me get straight into the exaltation part of it. Today's meditation, I will focus on Psalms 138. I repeat, Psalms 138. I give you thanks, O Lord, with all my heart. I'll sing your praises before the gods. I bow down before your holy temple as I worship. I praise your name for your unfailing love and faithfulness, for your promises are backed by all the honor of your name. As soon as I pray, you answer me. You encourage me by giving me strength. Every king in all the earth will thank you, Lord, for all of them will hear your words. Yes, they will sing about the Lord's ways, for the glory of the Lord is very great. This is a psalm written by King David during the time when he was king of Israel. And he is writing the psalms basically as a thanksgiving for the answered prayers that he submitted to God. Church, thanksgiving is an integral part of our praise, an integral part of our prayer life, an integral part of our worship. So we need to not to forget that this is an evident part of our lifestyle with God. Thanksgiving should be an integral part and be evident in our praise and worship, in our lifestyle, in our constant endeavor to know Him better. When we have unanswered prayers or answered prayers, we still need to give Him thanks, because if we don't, we are being selfish. Or if we don't, knowingly or unknowingly, it becomes our ignorance. And David reminds us in this psalm that we should give Him the praises and glory that is due to Him forever and ever. As we thank God for material and spiritual blessings, we should not forget to thank God for all the answered prayers as well. In our busy lifestyle, in our chaos, in the busyness of life, we may forget to even thank God for unanswered prayers. So let me remind you, church, that we need to also remind ourselves to praise God for all the answered prayers as well. And what happens in return? God richly blesses us and gives us more strength, more power to worship Him greatly. Remember, when you ask God to grant you His protection, strength, comfort, patience, love, or any other special needs, don't you think He will answer it? Of course He will, because He's your loving Father and we are His children. Let's be reminded about that and have a deeper relationship with Him. Jesus, come into our hearts and multiply your love so that we can be a love offering to others as well. So we have to be selflessly in response to give Him back the praise and glory at all times. He's the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords, and He's far above any other gods. I mean any other pagan gods. Even the kings in this land or the world praise Him and glorify Him because of His greatness. So church, let's get back to our Father. Let's get back to our Father in heaven, the creator of the universe, the creator of the earth, creator of the stars in the sky, creator of you and me. Let us submit our lives, hopes, dreams, aspirations, everything to Him. And then He will answer our prayers, because He said in our gospel, seek ye first the kingdom and His righteousness, and everything else will be added unto you. Our God and our Father will surely answer these prayer requests. He will bring you also out of trouble, the difficulties you face. He is your Father, Savior, Wonderful Counselor, Prince of Peace, and the Son of God. He has various factors that are various characteristics about Him. So you can cling on to one of his characteristics, one of his names, and be blessed. So church, as we worship him and glorify him with the praise and worship, sing it with all your heart. Invite him in your heart, because he has a piece of your heart. And that's why David was after his own heart. And trust in God and lean not on his understanding. Revere, submit, and surrender to him. This is all I can tell you, church. Let's exalt his name and praise him all. Shall we close our eyes? Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful time thou hast given us for this online service. We praise you and glorify you, dear. Even though we are just a mere speck of dust, we are just human, you still think of us worthy of your praises, dear. Dear Lord, forgive us from every situation, every sin that we have knowingly or unknowingly done. Cleanse us and wash us in your precious blood. Dear Lord, cleanse us as white as snow. Dear Lord, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you, dear Lord. We ask you to humble ourselves and submit ourselves once again, dear Lord, so that we will worship you in truth and spirit. Help us to grow in your presence, dear Lord. Help us to grow in the strength of the Lord. Help us to grow in Jesus. Help us to pursue you, Jesus, with all our heart, mind, body, and soul. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayer. We pray for the rest of the session into your hands. We submit the praise and worship team and the man of God who's going to praise you and spread the message of hope to the world, dear Father. Let it reach to the ends of the earth. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
John chapter 8, verses 12. The word of God says, "Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life." As we praise and worship God today, let's just remember we're nearing towards the end of this year, the year of growth. Let's reflect upon his loving kindness, God's loving kindness and faithfulness and mercy, which has never failed us throughout this entire year. Though we face times of tribulation and trouble, his faithfulness is one thing which has remained steadfast through it all. And as we praise and worship God today, let's open our eyes and witness his love for us. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do his work. And whatever we do, whether in word or deed, let us do it through Jesus Christ, our Savior, our God, our Father. Amen. Let's praise and worship him today.
Eyes of my heart. forward. Lord, if you don't go ahead of us, we don't want to take one step forward. For your presence is what we crave for, Lord. We want you, Lord. We want you all the time, Lord. Especially as we are coming to the end of this year. As we are drawing close to this challenging year. Lord, we don't want to move one step forward without you. We want to pursue you with all our hearts, with all our soul, with all our body, mind, strength. We want you, Lord. We want you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Now and forever, you are mine and I am yours, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Oh, how you hold our hearts together. How you comfort the brokenhearted. Oh, how you mend broken souls. Oh, how you heal broken hearts. You are a good Father. You're a merciful God. And we remember you for everything that you've done for us, Lord. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise, Lord. When we hear the word of God, Lord, speak to us directly, to our hearts, to our minds. May we reflect your glory. May we walk as you walked on earth, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done. We give you all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen. Amen.
Shalom, 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 shalom. I declare Jehovah shalom in the beginning into the places, the rooms, the church, wherever you are right now. I just declare Jehovah shalom. What a privilege and honor to be connected through the technology, and having Jesus in everything makes a huge difference. Hallelujah. The pandemic phase, the unpredictable environment outside, doesn't matter. Jesus has got it all covered. Do you want to give a big clap offering to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end? Just from wherever you are, come on, as a matter of agreement, let's do it together, because he deserves everything, every honor, all the worship, praises, and everything belongs to him. I just thank the Lord for this amazing platform, and I just thank the Lord for CTRR family in Dubai. Such a joy to come back once again. God has given me a word for your family, and for everyone connected across this platform, everyone, I just want to say a big welcome to you all in the name of our Savior Jesus Christ. God bless you all. I acknowledge our dear pastor, Blessing Cherian. He's not just a pastor, but an elder brother for us, for a lot of people, but especially for me. He's been a great inspiration and encouragement. And I just bless his presence as well, and I thank the Lord for this wonderful family and his leadership, and also the church leadership. And we had a wonderful worship as well. I just thank the Lord, and I give glory to the Lord for this wonderful worship team. We had a wonderful exhortation as well in the beginning. God bless you all. Before going further, I just want to say a quick prayer before we actually get into the word and just listen to what God has to speak to us. God has put me to speak to one person, I am ready to preach over here for that one person on the screen, because the word of God does go through every territory. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, as you have your eyes closed, and we're going to do some confessions together. If you want to just join with me, while we do some confessions and declarations and pray together. Hallelujah. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. We acknowledge that we are believers and Jesus Christ has given us authority against the power of the enemy, and nothing shall be by any means disturbed this setup going on right now. God Himself is the power behind this authority we carry. Oh, come on. God Himself is the power behind this authority we carry. Wow. I have been empowered with authority from the Lord Jesus Christ. Family, just join with me as we do the declarations. This is very strong. Hallelujah. And as for James chapter 4 verses 7, it says, in the name of Jesus Christ, I resist the enemy and I command every demonic spirit to flee. I just rebuke any reservations, any judgments, any conclusions coming to the people right now, streamed or tuned to the media or listening to the sermon right now. I just rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Come on, let's all get tuned in, because there's no distractions gonna come up while we listen to the word of God. Amen. Come on, we got a wonderful media team. They're praying with me right now as I'm sharing the prayers right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I also declare that, no weapon formed against me or my family or my ministry or my anything or my any association shall prosper, and nothing by any means will harm me or us. Come on. We just thank you, Lord. And at the end, I just want to declare Revelation chapter 12 verses 1. It's a confession. And they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. I declare and I decree that I have overcome Satan and its enemies by the blood of Jesus Christ and by the word of my testimony. Family, I just want to remind you all that your testimony is your power. Your testimony is a reminder of God's faithfulness in your life. And I just want to say a quick prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for the CTRR community and church. We as a family stand in your presence, and that we are in awe that you want us to call as your sons and daughters, and you have poured out your love upon us that we cannot even comprehend or understand the big massive love, and we just can't understand it till date, but we know it's so big. Father Lord, the reason for our survival is your love and mercy. So I'm asking Holy Spirit, come on family together, so I'm asking Holy Spirit to fill the sanctuary with the presence of Jesus. Reveal Him to us, reveal Jesus to us, hallelujah, in such a way that we have never known Him before. That is so good. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I pray that if there is anybody under the sound of my voice who doesn't know Him or Jesus intimately, that they will know Him before the service is over. For I decree that the kingdom has come within us, and your will shall be done here. For this, we give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praise, all the thanksgiving, and it's in mighty name of Jesus, the wonderful, majestic, holy, awesome, magnificent, great name of Jesus, we pray. And everybody that agrees with me right now through all the channels, say together, amen, amen, amen. Such a joy. Hallelujah. Always starting with a word of prayer and declarations and confessions does make a lot of difference. Amen. We've seen God working in the past. We have seen God working in the present. Won't we see God working in the future? Amen. Hallelujah. I just got a very quick reminder as a message, as a form of a capsule. In my language, I'll call it as heavenly gems, small heavenly gems for the day. And I'm sure it'll be a blessing. I know you've been probably overloaded with word through different servants of God over the past so many days. I believe it's the 18th day of the fasting prayer. And I just want to let you know that we are also in it with you together. I just praise the Lord for this ongoing fasting prayer. Hallelujah. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. Family, can you turn over to Psalms 121. Hallelujah. We just thank you, Lord. Psalms 121, you know the title, it says, A Song of Ascents. They were a pilgrims traveling on to the holy city, and they sing the songs as a matter of what God has done for them or what God will do for them. I would say it is almost a replica it's a metaphor of our own Christian journey. Amen. Hallelujah. So Christian life is not just a bypass. You have seen bypass roads or highways in back in Asia or India or even in some countries as well. Bypass, or take that bypass, you'll get there straight. No, there's no bypass in Christian life. This is a journey. This is a journey, and you will have to go through that way. But there is this journey when you are with God. It is called as the highway of holiness, as per Isaiah chapter 35. And you know what? Who is the ownership of your vehicle? God is the ownership. Hallelujah. So he drives, he ordains, he makes ways right straight for you to travel. So I'm gonna speak on Psalms chapter 121, and my mandate and my declaration throughout the sermon and throughout my life is that he increase and I decrease, because we are all empty vessels and channels. It's like a conduit pipe, I always say. When we share messages, when we share word, when we intercede, when we do anything for the Lord, it is just that we are all empty vessels. It's like conduit pipe connected, or I would say my GPS tuned into the throne room of grace, and he just pours it out, we just pour that out, all right? We just vessels. So it's not me, it's the Holy Spirit. I give him all the glory. Psalms 121 starts with a very familiar verse. It says, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Family, there is a system given by God, right? You got a system. You are created in whose image? God's own image. You got eyes, you got nose, you got lips. You got a lot of systems working together and part of a very big system. And it is the best creation of God ever, humans. And it is the best computer ever with some sort of sense. Hallelujah. It knows when to work, and God has computerized this very well, customized it very well. But the most important thing in your whole system is eyes. The reason is very simple. I was meditating in the presence of the Lord as to why, Lord, this eyes is so important. God showed me various aspects. And one of the things, I told this illustration in one of the previous sermons, but I just want God a leading to share it with you. All right. Back in our old days, especially when you are young as well, in the college days, you like shopping. And even now, young adults or even old people, they like shopping. All right. I'm not trying to differentiate here, but shopping. All right. When you go into a shop, especially Indians, all right? When you go into a shop, you get in and take an example of a shoe, all right? A shoe, and you love that brand so much, and you just you just go there, you wear it, and you try it, and at the end, hold on, there might be a lot of people around, and when you take the shoe in your hand, the leather, for example, the texture, everything looks good, but at the end, when you slowly lift the shoe a bit more up, you see the sole, all right? And the sole on the and under the sole, when you have a look, there's a small tag called a price tag. When you have a look at the price tag, then immediately your mouth or your heart, more than everything, the first thing that works is your eyes. you have a look at that soul, okay, fine. Then the messages start coming back to the brain, and then your other organs start reacting. Your hand starts reacting, saying that, okay, fine. Let's keep it down. And you look to the right, you look to the left, and you see there's no one around, and you keep the shoe back at that same place. I'm trying to remind you over here, your eyes sometimes can do a lot of talking. Your eyes convey a lot of messages. Now, the illustration over here is just very simple. Might be taken in a joke, but it's actually a very real-time scenario. I can speak about faith, God willing, sometime later, but then because it is that desire you want in that shoe which made you look on that shoe. But once you realize that there is a huge lot of price to be paid on that shoe, you could not meet the desire because you need to pay the price, all right, to get that desire, all right. And in our Christian life, there's something called faith, and that is our currency. You need to exercise the price of faith in whatever situations. If your desire comes in well with God, God has given you a very free way of channel to get towards His will. Use faith. Faith is a substance, all right? So just coming back, so under the soul, you saw the price tag. So you use your eyes, right? So I'm just trying to focus right nowadays. The devil or the demons or whatever outside, the enemy does try to change or just divert the focus of your eyes to unwanted things. But the Spirit of the Lord is just strongly reminding someone on the screen, someone in the church, someone in the community, someone among this platform right now, that where have your eyes got into at the current moment? When the world outside needs you, my friend, where is your eyes going to? Your eyes need to go to that holy mountain. Hallelujah. Psalms 3 verse 3 and 4. I'm not sure whether anyone remembers, but it says, "But you, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head." Next verse, Psalms 3 verse 4, it says, "I cried to the Lord with my voice, and He heard me from His holy hill." Which hill are you looking forward to? He heard me from His holy hill. Family, I just want to declare one thing over here right now. If you are looking forward to hearing from the Lord, you will hear voice from His holy hill. But the moment where you feel that you're not hearing anything back, do not worry. Just stay focused on His holy hill, because my God can even talk in your moment of silence. Yes, He does talk. Don't even think about God just getting away from you, from your side, because I'm just going to meditate on few verses in Psalms 121, where He neither slumbers nor sleeps. Hey, my friend, January, February, March, April, May, till now December, you know, it came a situation where you couldn't run to hospitals, you couldn't run to universities, you couldn't run to your workplaces. Hey, you couldn't talk to even your boss. There was a time when you couldn't even talk to your most closest friend, even your spiritual friend. But has the keeper of Israel, the maker of Israel, the your creator, your master, has He ever slept? No, He sustained you. He sustained you from Jan till December. Come on, if anyone is there under the sound of my voice, you want to give a big shout offering or a clap offering to the King of Kings, for He sustained you, my family. He is good. He is so good. I can feel His presence right now. I just declare His presence over the screens, over the church, over the community right now. Hallelujah. So there's one thing I want to come back. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Family, focus on your eyes. Your eyes. It says my eyes. It doesn't say I lift up the eyes. It says my eyes to the hills. And I was very specific in saying that in Psalms chapter 3 and 4. And He heard me from His holy hill, which means you look to the hills. That's good. But make sure you look to the hill where, you know, which is holy. All right? Because Because when you are in a problem, when you are in a situation, when you are in a very comfortable situation, lot of hills can come up round and round, surrounding you, lot of hills. And I want to remind you in the Holy Spirit that, family, my friend, can you just make sure in the Spirit that you're looking at the right hill? From whence comes my help? It says, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Isaiah 55 verses 12, it says, for you shall go out with joy and be led out with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth into singing before you. Into singing before you. Oh, come on. You know, when you actually wait on the Lord, you there is a moment when God will bring you out into joy and you will lead out in peace before the mountains which made you down. Since you looked at the right hill, since you looked at the holy hill, God will make sure that you will come out in joy. Come on. It's for any someone over here. If you want to receive it, say, I receive it, and say, amen. Hallelujah. And Psalms 125 verses 1 and 2, it says, those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved, but abides forever. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people from this time forth and forever. If you want to just say amen, I just declare this, Father Lord, over everyone connected over here, Father Lord, because those who trust in the Lord are like mounts and it can never be moved. All right, so verse number two, my family, please don't get distracted in between. There is this thing we always used to get used to. First, in the earlier time before the corona came up, there is this beautiful system called church, and we got Sunday and Friday. In some countries Friday, in some countries Sunday. We worship the Lord, but how many times have we taken this for granted? All right, talk to yourself. I'm talking to myself. Hey, Sumit, how many times have you taken the church or the gathering for granted? Now that this COVID-19 and all the restrictions in the world came into place, now that Zoom and YouTube and Facebook has come in, and there is this particular situation I want you to remind. Now, this is the time when God actually talks about checking, or you know, or having overseeing his children on what they do in secret. All right. So nowadays, the earlier phase was you were in the church, but now is a real test time. All right. So you might have your video switched off, or you might be doing anything, but I just want you to give maximum importance to the word, because that has changed the life of millions and millions. This is the source of everything good. This is the source of eternal life. It reveals your past, it reveals your present, it reveals your future. And there is one way out of this. This is Jesus. Hallelujah. All right, so my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. All right, my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Holy Spirit is reminding me to go into the life of Daniel, a man of prayer. Can we all go to Daniel chapter 6. I just want to give a quick overview before we go into the Daniel chapter 6. You know, what was the position of Daniel? Daniel was among the three governors. Now, to become one among the three governors, it is always mentioned about him being distinct used because he's got a spirit of excellence. That's, it's not only you know, it's written in the word, but the people who are not in the under the covering of the God, which means people outside of Israelites also recognize the people around him, the people subject to the king recognize, the king himself recognize, the queen recognize. Yes, Daniel has got a spirit of excellence. I'm going to talk to someone on the screen who has got a spirit of excellence, or who used to have one, or who has lost, or who is thinking that, oh, I've lost the spirit of excellence I used to have. This word of the Lord is for you, my dear friend. You will not lose anything, because my God is a God of progression. He always makes people recover. He resolves. All right? He always makes sure that resolution takes place. Resolution takes place. He always is a God of second chance. He always loves you the way you used to worship. He always loves the way you used to pray. He always loves the way you used to intercede. Yes, He always loves the way you used to sit in His Lord's presence and sit for hours. But where has it all gone, my friend? I'm speaking to someone on the screen. Just make sure that, you know, if you are that person, I don't want you to just comment or anything. Speak to yourself. Comment with the Holy Spirit. Talk to Him. Just have a quick conversation. Jesus, is this person talking about me right now? Because it is not that person talking. It is the Holy Spirit revealing about someone. And I'm going to talk about that person who had the spirit of excellence like Daniel. All right, so focus on the Holy Spirit right now. So it says Daniel was one of the main officials or governors or presidents, whatever you want to call them, all right? And chapter 6 verses 1 to 10 is the main part of the chapter, which I'll be looking forward to. So I will quickly go across to verse number 3. It says, then Daniel distinguished himself above the governors and satraps because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought to setting him over the whole realm. All right, not the point. 3 governors, and he was very much distinguished because he had a spirit of excellence. And now the king has decided to give him the biggest post ever, which is almost next to the king. Now this is really important, my family. The moment this thing came across, the promotion came across, the uplifting statement came across, I just want to remind you all, that was when the problem started. I want to remind someone of, you got some oppression, you got some stoppage, you got some obstruction for you to move ahead in the Lord, or you got some really big fight going on in whatever territory you are in. It reminds me of a very old illustration or a small phrase even. When a running cart goes down the hill, how much of a barking dogs which comes on the way, which can that will not stop the running cart. I know I'm pretty sure you're able to visualize it, right? When it comes down the hill, how many barking dogs comes on the way, it will never stop the running cart. Now what I'm trying to tell is that when Holy Spirit has anointed someone across something and has given authority that is from the Lord, and you are like a big cart and that is being driven by the Holy Spirit, nothing can stop what is in your way, because it is God who is in control and you are in the highway of holiness. Amen. But make sure inside the covering of the Lord. All right, so when you have the situation like Daniel, and you go to verse number 4, so the governors and satraps sought to find some charge against Daniel concerning the kingdom. All right, concerning the kingdom, very important, not that word kingdom, but they couldn't find no charge of fault because he was faithful. Underline the word faithful. Okay, number 1, kingdom and faithful. Nor was there any error or fault found in him. All right. How is that possible, my family, that a normal man like us was put in a kingdom and he was found faithful and there was no right or error found in him? And the ironical part is that he himself was the person the people were after, even though he was found faithful, even though he was a person found with no errors at all. You know what? I just want to remind someone over here, and reminding myself as well. If you're being faithful in the presence of the Lord, in the kingdom. Now that kingdom is different, but in the kingdom perspective, I believe we are all in the kingdom culture. We are on the kingdom governance. We all belong to the kingdom of God. Be faithful in the kingdom which has been assigned to you. In the kingdom where you are in the world, be faithful. In the authorities, among the law where you are put in, be faithful. Be faithful. Because there will be coming a time where the faithfulness will be tested. Be tested. But then you will rely on the Lord who has given you that particular level. Now, because of your faithfulness, continue being faithful, says the Spirit of the Lord to someone on the screen. Continue being faithful. I know it's tough. The Spirit of the Lord says it's tough sometimes to survive in that particular scenario. May it be wherever, you know what it is, all right? Be faithful wherever you are. Do not run away. Whatever assignments or responsibilities you have been kept, be faithful, says the Spirit of the Lord. Then these men said, who? The other people who were against Daniel. Verse number 5, we shall not find any charge against this Daniel unless we find it against him concerning the law of his God. Oh, this is really a big test. All right, if it was told concerning the law of the king, or the kingdom, or the Babylon king, that was a bit different scenario. And this scenario is even more different. It says, we shall not find any charge against this Daniel unless we find it against him concerning the law of his God, which means now the people are against Daniel and his faith in the living God. When people or the enemy come against testing your faith in the living God, do not fall for that test. Do not fall for that test. Yes, this is written. They did not test anything, but they tested against him concerning the law of his God. Whose God? Daniel's God. Yes. Family, at these times, I want to remind someone over here, do not fail on any test being put by the enemy concerning the law of God. This is very important. At these end times, the enemy is like a roaring lion. Not he is a roaring lion, it's just a toothless lion. But I'm trying, he just disguises, he tries to test you. He tries to test you in all formats. He tries to test you in your personal life. He tries to test you in your family life. He tries to test you in your community or your church life. He tries to test you in your work. He just tries to test you against whatever things you have in place with reference to your relationship with Christ. Do not give anything away, whatever you're built in Christ, because anything that can survive till the last time or the end times is Christ. That's the only takeaway you can have from your life, being in Christ. Hallelujah! Alright, family, time is going on. I'm aware of the time. So just going forward quickly. Then, verse number 6. So these governors and satraps thronged before the king and said thus to him, King Darius, live forever. Thronged means just to push in, all right? They have never become so serious earlier, but now that they have realized that Daniel has been distinguished, they started becoming really busy with their work, all right? All the governors of the kingdom, the administrators and satraps, the counselors and advisors have consulted together to establish a royal statute and to make a firm decree that whoever petitions any god or man for 30 days except you, O king, shall be cast into the den of lions. All right? What a beautiful unity people have, or the gun or those officials had against one man. Right, it was told, I think in in the book of Samuel, it's told about David and the Philistines coming against one man, David. Almost a similar replica or a similar situation, or of all the officials, the governors, administration consulted, together to establish a royal statute, that no one would be, no one would be worshipping or, just hold on. That whoever petitions any god or man for 30 days, except you, O king, shall be cast into the den of lions, which means there's not no other god or any person, it's just the king of Babylon. All right, so they requested the king to establish the decree and sign the writing, all right? And so it cannot be changed, it seems. Therefore, King Darius signed the written lease. Family, now I want you to go to verse number 10. Daniel 6 verse 10. Hang on for anyone joining in between. Hang on. We're talking about Daniel and also Psalms 121. Now when Daniel knew, all right, Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went home. This is my main message. Now when Daniel knew, okay, so how did Daniel know about it? You remember in Colossians chapter 4 verses 2, it says, continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. Family, listen to that verse again. You know this verse, Colossians 4 verses 2. Continue earnestly in prayer, being vigilant in it with thanksgiving. In this season, God has been strongly speaking to me. Sumit, make sure you are continuing earnestly in prayer, but be vigilant. Know what's going around. You need to know what's going around. Not that the entire world is against you. It's just because the word of God has been written. Be vigilant. Daniel, I believe, was vigilant. Daniel knew what was going out, what was going on, what is going around. Daniel knew it. Family, if it's the person like Daniel, whom you feel that I've come across a situation in my life where I'm not aware of things going around and something has happened to me, I just declare the Spirit of the Lord who was upon Daniel into your life. Be vigilant. Know what's going on. You know, when you have to be a testimony in the world, you need to know what's going on. You know, when you want to speak to the people around, you need to know what's going around the people. If you want to be influential in getting into territories where the Spirit of the Lord needs to work and needs to work through you, you need to use your wisdom, divine wisdom, and be vigilant. I would say, family, being vigilant is the most important virtue in this season. People have used this vigilant and discernment and all these words in vain. Relationships have been broken. A lot of communities have been disturbed because the Christians use the discernment and the vigilant so-called word in vain. The reason is very simple. When God gives you a spirit of discernment, when God reminds you to be vigilant of your surroundings, at the same time, God asks you to use a spirit of wisdom to deal. When God shows you something about someone, always remember that any negative things in any people is not because of the people, it's because of the spirit of the evil one behind the people. I'm trying to remind someone over here, let's be real people. Let's make our situations real. Let's be warriors for Christ. Let's be generals for Christ. Because the reason is, if we are not vigilant, It's a big issue. But when you are vigilant, you'll also need to use your spiritual wisdom. Daniel, what did he do? When he came to, it says in verse number 10, now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, what did he go against the governors? Did he use his influence? Did he gather his friends? Abednego and the other Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, the three friends, or his colleagues or anyone, and go against or use his influence to talk to the king? No. He just remained, and like it's written, he just remained still, and he was just waiting as per the verse, be still and know that I'm God. Family, I'm reminding someone over here, we need to be vigilant. Pray to the Lord, talk to the Lord, talk to the Holy Spirit. He will let you know what's going on. We will need to know what's going around. God has been strongly speaking to me that when we're talking about the country of Australia, the Christians will get an influence, a great influential position because of the levels God is going to give to his children in the society or in the corporate level. We can get into parliaments, we can get into the government positions to influence and to spread the word of God in a global level, in a national level. I just want to declare the same over the CTRR family right now. I just pray that the Spirit of the Lord energizes and just pushes in a lot of power of the Holy Spirit into your community and to your channels connected with you to make influential changes based on Christ in your territory. Now, because of probably one prayer of yours or because of one declaration of yours in those offices or corporates, it can positively impact the whole nation of Dubai for Christ. Amen. If you want to receive that, say amen, amen, amen. Yes, it is for me. Hallelujah. Oh, come on. I just feel like preaching. Amen. I just thank the Lord. Hallelujah. So now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went home. He didn't go to the woods, Sarah. He didn't go to the school. He didn't go to the university. He didn't go to the pastor. He didn't go to his friend's house. He didn't go anywhere. He could have just went somewhere, no? Yes. But he went home. Family, the best place you can go to when you have a problem is your war room. You know that a beautiful Christian movie, War Room? That it was a small closet which that lady prayed. Just a, you know, kind of a small serial or a movie. But I'm trying to remind you over here, when you know when something is going on and it's going to really disturb you, I'm reminding to someone in the screen, do not react. Be still. Go back to your home. Go to your home like Daniel. Go to that secret prayer room. And I say, go further. He did not go to the secret inner chamber or the inner bedroom where there is no light. No, he did not go there. He went to the room. All right, I'll just go to that verse again. Well, you can just look at the verse. So he went to the room with the open window, right? He went to the room with the open window. And it says it is the most visible. Now, this is really good. Family, stick on with me on the screens right now. Daniel went to his room, which is most visible, or the light is just coming in, or that is that point where the window is open. And the best part is that window faced Jerusalem and not the palace of Babylon. Yes, you know that window when Daniel was praying, that window wasn't facing Babylon but was facing Jerusalem. I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. I just thank the Lord for this word. Family, when you are praying, focus on the mountain of God, the hill, the holy hill, when you pray. Like Daniel, he opened the windows and prayed looking at Jerusalem. Hallelujah. And I'm going to end the sermon very quick, very quick. He did not pray once. He just kept on praying, possibly about three times a day and every day. He did not made sure that he did not miss out. No matter what's going to happen, because it is being signed. Family, if anything is being signed in anywhere which is probably against you or your beliefs, hang on, hang on, hang on. Because it is all what you need is God. It is Him alone we need. It is Jesus whom alone we need. Pursue Jesus, not anything else. It is Him alone we need. Family, from wherever you are, if you can rise up to your feet, just rise up. But if you're just sitting, or if you're driving, or if you're involved in something else, don't worry. Just focus on, as I'm going to pray for you. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Father. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. I just thank you, Lord. Lord, we remember, Father, Lord, when Daniel knew about what was going on, he knew, because there is that beautiful spirit within him which makes him vigilant. Knows what's going on around, and he didn't go to the palace to react. He always reminded himself, just be still and know that he serves the God of Israel. And what he did, he went home. Come on, family, at these times I want to remind someone on the screens, when you come across very unpredictable seasons, many unpredictable written statements in your job, in your workplace, in your community, in your family, I just want to remind someone over here, and I want to remind myself as well, go home, or go to your secret prayer tower. Now, secret prayer tower doesn't mean that you're in a room completely enclosed. Look open, have a faith, and look and pray, just like Daniel, opening the windows. Probably you can't see Jerusalem physically, but I'm trying to say in the spirit, you know, if you're distressed, look to the Lord who can answer you from His holy hill. Rakabau shabu rampe riampe. Libra bakhorabau shabthorabau siamthularagasya. Family, everyone, have your eyes closed. Let's gonna pray. I'm gonna pray together. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Hallelujah. And sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The last verse, the Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. If you are wavering in your faith, if you are a little shaky in your faith, I want to declare this word right now, that the Lord shall preserve you. Preserve. Preservation of the Lord, preservation by Jesus, or for your going out and your coming in from this time forth. And this is the word for this time, this hour, this second, over you or your family and for everyone connected. Hallelujah. Close your eyes. I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray over you. For whoever, you just need not respond in comments. Just be in the spirit of the Lord. I can see the stream going on right now. Father, I thank you for you are my ever-present help in times of need. In Jesus' name I pray. Father, I thank you for you never sleep nor slumber over issues of my life. Wow. I declare today that I am protected from every evil attacks of the day. In Jesus' name, I shall never lack help. I never lack help in Jesus' name. It is written concerning me that I will divide the spoil of the land with the great and mighty, and it shall be so in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Power of redemption, power of sanctification, power of resurrection, power of provisions. I just want to declare this over this community right now, Lord. Restore to us the joy of the salvation. In case anyone has lost your joy of salvation, I just declare, Father Lord, the joy which we find from you, Lord, righteousness, peace, and joy into this family in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, I thank you for your word. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord who made heavens and earth. Thank you, Lord, for the reminder of Daniel, Lord. Very short message, but I believe you have spoken, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen. Family, thank you all for staying on till the end of this message. I believe God has spoken to you. For anyone joining at the end, this message was about lifting your eyes to the hills, and your help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. And also reflecting on Daniel's life, he went home to pray. He didn't go anywhere else when he came to know about the written statement by the king, which was against his life. Bless you all. I thank you all. Love you all. Love you, Pastor Blessing. Bless you. Glory be to God. Amen. Shalom. Amen.